So, good morning, class. Today we are discussing about reactive intermediates and their detection, and especially we will discuss about the carbocation and carbon ion. First of all, let us see what are reaction intermediates. So they are actually the intermediate species formed during a reaction. When you perform a certain reaction, you start from the reactants, and when the reaction is complete, you get product. And between the state of reactant and product, all the other intermediate species form during the course of reaction, they are called reaction intermediates. So you can define it like a reaction intermediate or an intermediate molecular entity, that could be ion, atom, molecule, which is formed during the reaction with a lifetime which is appreciably longer than a molecular vibration, and that is formed directly or indirectly from the reactant and reacts further to give the product. Again, it can be in the direct or indirect manner. So we call them the intermediates, the reaction intermediates. So few important characteristics of reaction intermediates are, first of all, they are the intermediate entities. They are not a reactant and they are not product. They are between these two structures. Then the second thing is their lifetime is actually low and their stability is less as compared to the reactant and product both. So they cannot have some independent existence. They are formed from the reactant and ultimately they have to convert themselves into the product in order to achieve the stability. And lastly, they are formed during the course of the reaction. So it is not that a reactant is forming intermediate somehow. Whenever it is subjected to a particular chemical reaction, then only it can form the reactive intermediate. So, in the organic chemistry, many such reactive intermediates are known. In majority of cases, we see ionic intermediates and they are called carbocation and carbon ion. Carbocation are the intermediates in which carbon atom contains positive charge, and carbon ions, they are also reactive intermediates, and in that case, carbon atom contains negative charge. So these are the two major intermediates which are seen generally in the organic chemistry. But otherwise, carbenes, free radicals, nitrines and nitrinium ion, they are also known to form as an intermediate in the organic reactions. So today, for this lecture, we will focus on the carbocations and carbon ions, and maybe in the next lecture, we will discuss about the remaining intermediates. As well as we will see how these intermediates can be identified, how you can detect their presence during the course of reaction. What is the proof that we have that a reactive intermediate has been formed? So yes, we have so many methods, and with the help of these analytical tools, we can find out the presence of the reactive intermediate. We can trace their, we can detect them, we can trace their presence. So that we will also see. First to see the carbocations. Now, carbocation is what? It is an ion and it contains a positively charged carbon atom. So when the carbon atom is having a positive charge, you call it a carbocation. And in the carbocation, you can have a carbenium species, carbenium ion, that is a trivalent positive species like CH3, C2H5. And it can be a carbonium ion, which is a pentavalent positive species, or you can say this is a non-classical carbocation. So how the carbocation is formed? As we all know that when the reactants are converted into products in any kind of chemical reaction, this actually passes through the reaction path. And in this reaction path, some bonds are broken, some new bonds are formed. And the first thing that will happen is the breaking of a bond. So when a covalent bond breaks, you know that a covalent bond, it contains two electrons. And in the organic chemistry, generally all bonds are covalent bonds. So when a covalent bond breaks, it has two electrons, and there could be two possibilities. Like the first possibility is when the bond is breaking, we are getting two species after breaking of a bond. So when one species takes up all the electrons and the other species is devoid of those paired electron of the covalent bond, so in that case you call it a heterolytic fission. And one you will get one species with a positive charge, that will be a carbocation, and one species with a negative charge, so that could be any other ion. And if the two electrons of a covalent bond, both the species, they take up one and one electron, so in that case free radicals are formed, that you called as homolytic fission, when the equal distribution of the shared pair of electron takes place. So when the fission of a covalent bond takes place during the course of a chemical reaction, it can be the homolytic fission, when both the species those are generating after the breaking of the covalent bond, they get one and one electron each, that is the generation of free radicals, and you call it a homolytic fission. But when there is a heterolytic fission, only one of the species goes away with all the electrons, and in that case one positive and one negative charge is generated. So your carbocation and carbonyl, they are actually generated by the heterolytic fission of a covalent bond. In the case of carbocation, the carbon species, it takes it loses all the electrons, and the other species takes up the electron pair, and the carbon becomes positive. It contains a positive charge, although it is unstable in nature, but the positive charge develops over the carbon atom, so you call it a carbocation. And if you talk about the carbonyl species, so in that case the carbon atom takes up all the electrons, the electron pair, and in due to this it develops a negative charge. So these two reactive intermediates, these two ionic intermediates, the carbocation and carbonyl, they are formed by the heterolytic fission of covalent bonds. So we were discussing that the carbocations, they can be of two types. We can have a trivalent positive species, which is known as CH3C2H5, or this can be a pentavalent species, again containing a positive charge, but with a non-classical structure. Now, this is the structure of carbocation when it has a planar sp3 hybrid structure. So CH3, simplest carbocation, we have positive charge is present on the carbon, and all the three hydrogen, they are present in the plane, and that is why you call it a sp2 hybridization. The one unhybridized pz orbital, it remains perpendicular to the molecular plane, and this is the orbital which contains the positive charge. This is empty, does not contain any electron, and this is the actually tertiary butyl cation ion, and again it also has a planar geometry. So generally carbocation, because they are lacking one valency of the carbon, generally carbon is having a tetrahedral structure. So when it loses one electron pair, that tetrahedral structure is lost, and now the carbocation, it attains a planar geometry, a planar structure, which represent the sp2 hybridization in the carbocation species. So different type of carbocations are mentioned here in the slide, like this is edmontyl carbocation, one trishmobaryl type of carbocation, then a triphenyl methyl type of carbocation. This is a propeller shaped carbocation, and these are the simpler ones. So this is the structure. Now let us see how the carbocations are generated and what will be their fate. Fate is to what species they are going to convert themselves. That is the fate of the carbocation. So generally we have two ways to form carbocation. First is a direct ionization method. Direct ionization method is when one of the species attached to the organic species, it is actually more electronegative, and that is why it tends to take up all the electron pairs with itself, and you see a heterolytic bond fission here, as a result of which the one electron pair of this covalent bond, they are taken up by the X, and the carbonic species in which the carbon is present, it actually develops a positive charge over it due to the loss of electron. So this is a direct ionization method. The second method is addition of a positive species to an unsaturated system. So now what happens in this case, this is some unsaturated system and there is no bond breaking. Rather, a positive species is actually getting attached to the unsaturated system and transferring the charge over it. Like this H plus is getting attached to the carbon atom here, which is doubly bonded, and now as a result of this, what happens? The carbon develops a positive charge. So this is the second way, second method for the generation of carbocation. Now, after the carbocation is generated, now you can see that the carbon is containing positive charge, and now it will look for electrons, right? When it is containing positive charge, it needs electron to satisfy the charge. So now it becomes what? Now it will look for the electrons in other species and it becomes electrophile. It is looking for the species which contain excess electron density. So what are the reactions of the carbocation which shows the fate of carbocation? The first is combination with a species possessing an electron pair. So this carbocation will look for some species which contains a negative charge, which contains electron pair, which it can take up and satisfy the positive charge. So it can combine with some negative species, like the R plus is combining with X minus to form RX. Now the carbocation, this may also lose a proton from the adjacent atom. So here you can see that the charge on the carbon is actually lost by transferring that charge to a more stable proton, and therefore a double bond is developed at this phase. This is the reaction that can take place after the generation of carbocation. Third is the rearrangement reaction. The charge can take up the rearrangement reaction, and after the rearrangement, new product can be formed. So like here you can see the positive charge is present on the CH2. Now it has transferred itself due to hyperconjugation on the secondary carbon. Then again on the primary carbon, the charge is present, and now it is transferred to the tertiary carbon. Tertiary carbon is which is attached to three other carbons, and secondary carbon is which is attached to two other carbons. So in case of the carbocation, it always tries to take up the stable structure. What will be the most stable structure? When the positive charge is present on the tertiary carbon. So generally, if the primary carbocations are formed during a particular reaction, the charge is actually rearrange itself and tries to go to the either the secondary or tertiary, whichever is possible. It goes to the secondary carbon in this case and to the tertiary carbon in this case. So in this manner, it actually stabilizes itself. And when the intermediate becomes stable, its lifetime becomes a quite bit long, and now it becomes easy to detect it. One example is given here, that is the pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement reaction, and it involves the generation of carbocation. So you can see that this is the pinacol, and when the one proton is lost here, it attaches to the oxygen attaches to a proton, and the positive charge is rearranges itself to come at the carbon center, and the carbon center containing the positive charge, again the positive charge is relocated on another carbon atom, and finally it travels to the carbon chain like this and sent to the hydrogen, which is attached on another oxygen. So like you can see, the pinacol, it rearranges simply in the presence of H plus ion and gives the product, that is pinacolone. So this type of rearrangements are quite possible in case of the carbocations. The fourth and the last is addition. So addition is like this carbocation R plus, it gets added over the double bond. So the positive charge is transferred to another carbon atom. So this R is getting attached here, RCC. And the positive charge on the R will be transferred at the C. So this is containing now the positive charge. By the addition of a cation to the neutral molecule. So now you can see that this cation is added to the neutral molecule. The H plus is added to this acetone, and the carbocation is generated. Then H plus, the proton, is added to the acetylene molecule, and again a carbocation is generated. And this ROR, it is also reacting with some electron deficient species, and as a result of this, there's a charge transfer reaction. This CH3 actually gives away all the electron to this BF4 minus, and as a result of this, a new carbocation is generated, which is CH3 plus, and it attacks over the oxygen, because the oxygen is containing electrons, right? So the CH3 plus, after the generation, it get attached to the oxygen molecule and transfer its positive charge there. From the oxygen, it reaches to the R group, and now with the removal of one carbocation, you get a final product. So this is a substituted ether, which is actually developed by such a reaction. Then we also have a method by the heterolytic fission of a carbon heteroatom bond. So this is the most common method for the generation of carbocation, in which we are using some alkyl halide. So these alkyl halide contains an alkyl group, this is R, and halide, that is X. So this halide is what, when the solvolysis is performed in the presence of solvent, this actually takes up all the electron pair of the covalent bond. And as a result of this, what happens? The R develops a positive charge and X develops a negative charge. So after the development of negative charge on X, now what are the possibilities? What are the possibilities here? So this X can go to combine with the acetate, then it can combine with the para-nitrobenzene, in which the charge is present on the heteroatom, right? Then the tosylate and the trifluoroacetate. So these are the possibilities, and here the carbocation is generated by the heterolytic fission of a carbon heteroatom bond. Then next is by heterolysis fission of a carbon heteroatom bond to form the onium salt. So what is onium salt? You can see here, this is the onium salt in which oxygen is containing a positive charge. This is the onium salt. So you can see the reaction. We have an alkyl halide here, when in the presence of the Ag plus ion, the electrons are actually rearranged, and the X minus actually removes it from here and combines with the Ag, so it becomes AgX, and as a and now in this type of reaction, you can see what are the different possibilities. So ROH plus H plus. Now what happens? This onium salt is formed. The H attaches itself to the oxygen, and R plus is generated. Then the similar reaction is possible when we have an ether here. So in the ether molecule also we have oxygen, and on this oxygen the hydrogen attaches. Positive charge develops on the oxygen, and finally the carbocation is generated. Similarly, in the RNH2 amine molecule, again the proton attacks and protonate the nitrogen, and now the positive charge from the nitrogen, it is taken up by the alkyl group, and R plus, that is carbocation, is generated. The last is the thioalcohol. So in case of the thioalcohol, RSH, again the proton attacks on the molecule and it gets attach itself on the sulfur due to the presence of electron on the sulfur. And the positive charge that is now present on the sulfur, it actually relocates itself on the alkyl group. So it becomes R plus plus H2S. Then the carbocation can also be generated by the heterolysis of alkyl diazonium salt. Diazonium salts are those which contain a diazo group, that is N double bond N. And when a diazo group, it undergoes the heterolysis process, in that case, one carbocation is generated and nitrogen is released. So this is a very easy reaction, very quick reaction, and a spontaneous one, because nitrogen molecule is quite a stable molecule, and release of nitrogen in this manner, it is very spontaneous and feasible. So this could be one of the easiest method to prepare the carbocation. Then another method is by removal of an electron from the neutral molecule or a free radical. So if you remove one electron from a free radical, it becomes positively charged, right? And now in this manner, you have converted the free radical into a carbocation. Now let us see what are the different reactions of carbocation. So like I told you, when the carbon atom, it develops a positive charge over it, now it becomes a strong electrophile. It will look for those species which contain the negative charge, unused electron density, electron pair, lone pair of electron. So all the electron rich species, they will be the target of this carbocation molecule, and you can call it as electrophile. So this R plus cation, it can act as electrophile and react with a nucleophile. For example, R plus Nu minus R Nu. So all the nucleophiles, they are looking for the positive charge. If a species is containing electron, it will look for the positive charge. So they are the nucleophiles. And the carbocation we have is, it is electrophile because it is looking for electrons. So they both can combine and they can satisfy their electron requirements. And in this manner, they can form a stable product. Now, some carbocations, they act as a Bronsted acid and they also lose a proton. For example, like here, you can see this is a carbocation and it loses one positive H plus, that is one proton. And after the loss of one proton, you can see that a double bond is generated. So this type of reactions are also feasible because loss of a proton is quite an easy thing to rearrange the electrons. Then primary and secondary carbocation, they are often seen to undergo Wegener-Mirwin rearrangement. And this rearrangement actually takes place by an inotropic 1-2 shift of a hydride or an alkyl anion. So here you can see the formation of the carbocation takes place at the initial part of the reaction. Initially, you can see that there is attack of because this is the carbocation, so how it will stabilize it? Now, the plus charge on the carbon will transfer itself on one of the hydrogen. And now what will happen? One hydride ion is lost and the plus charge is developed here on the carbon. So this is, first of all, loss of the hydride ion will be the first step. And the second step, now you can see that again a positive charge is present on the carbon, and due to the electronic rearrangement, one alkyl group is lost and now again a positive charge is developed. So what type of shift you can see? This is 1-2 shift, and also it is anisotropic. So first hydride minus ion is lost, and in the second case R minus is lost. So two anions are lost at first and second position. And in this manner, this reaction is called the Wegener-Mirwin rearrangement reaction. Generally, primary and secondary carbocation, they display such reaction. Then another reaction shown by the carbocation, this is the internal alkylation of a carbon-carbon double bond. And sometimes it may take place with a carbocation. So here you can see this is a carbocation containing two methyl groups. And after the rearrangement reaction, internal alkylation, so double bond electron, they are attacking on this positive charge, positively charged carbon atom, and there is a setup of an internal bond here. And as a result of this, the positive charge, it will transfer itself on this carbon atom. So new carbocation is formed here, and this is actually, this resulted from the internal alkylation of carbon-carbon double bond. Then fragmentation of the carbon chain of carbocation is also known. So what is fragmentation? When you are getting the two fragments. So one of the fragment is retaining the charge and other is developing a double bond. So here in this case, you can see we have a primary carbocation, and in this, the transfer of electron are in this direction. As a result of this, here we get a double bond and a new fragment is formed. And also, now you get a smaller carbocation as compared to the earlier one. Now it becomes smaller because a part of the carbocation is lost as a unsaturated fragment. Then the carbocations, they can be reduced to form a free radical or carbanion by the cathodic reduction. So this is the carbocation. Now if you add one electron to it, if you are performing the reduction of carbocation, you will get a free radical. So in the carbocation, we don't have any electron, but in the free radical, we have one electron. So that state can be achieved by reduction of the carbocation. Similarly, when you add two electrons here, now it is converted into carbanion. So when you are adding two electrons, it becomes carbon ion. When you are adding one electron, it becomes a free radical. So that actually depends entirely on the condition of the reduction. Now let us see the stability. So how you can see that which carbocation is more stable and which is less stable? In a general sense, if you can say all the carbocations, they are unstable species, right? They are not the stable product or reactant that they can live so long. So generally, they all are unstable because they are the reaction intermediates. But yes, we can compare the relative stability of different type of carbocations. That is basically it depends on whether the charge is present on which type of carbon atom, whether charge is on the primary carbon, on the secondary carbon, or on the tertiary carbon. So when the charge, the positive charge, is present on primary carbon, then you call it a primary carbocation. So only one carbon atom is attached to it. Then if the charge is present on the secondary carbon, that is the carbon which is attached to two carbon atoms, two other carbons, you call it a secondary carbonium ion. Then in the third case, we have a tertiary carbon here, and this is the tertiary carbocation or carbonium ion. So now, how you can identify their relative stability? How we can find out how we can correlate their stability? So generally, their stability is in the order that is tertiary is the most stable one, then the secondary, and finally the primary. So this is the order of their stability. And if you account the reason, what is the reason behind this the sequence of stability among different carbocations? So let us see one by one. This is primary carbonium ion, and you can see that it is attached to one carbon species, and we know that the alkyl groups, they are known for their plus I effect. The plus I effect is when the electron density is released. So this alkyl group is releasing electron density toward the positive charge, and induction is coming from one alkyl group only. In case of the secondary carbonium ion, now the induction is coming from the two carbon atoms. Two alkyl groups are releasing their electrons to the positive charge. So how the stability will increase? To increase the stability of the carbocation, this charge has to become less intense. So any group which is attached to the carbon, any group which is attached to the positively charged carbon, if it intensifies the charge on it, then it will destabilize it. And if it satisfies the charge, then it will stabilize it. So whenever we have a plus I alkyl group attached to the carbon atom, it will stabilize the positive charge by releasing the electron density. So in this manner, this is a stabilizing effect. It will stabilize the carbonium ion. So when you have one alkyl group, you can see a little bit of stabilization due to plus I effect. Then you have in the secondary carbonium ion, you have two alkyl group attached. So more stabilization is observed because now we have two alkyl groups. And finally, in the tertiary carbonium ion, here you can see that three alkyl groups are attached to the carbon atom which contains a positive charge, and due to this, now you can see that more stabilization is obtained. So that is how you can attribute their stability order, that is the increasing stabilization by induction. So the tertiary carbocation, tertiary carbonium, it is the most stable one, followed by the secondary, and the least stable will be the primary carbonium ion. So the most stable of all the alkyl cation is tertiary butyl cation, and the ethane and propane, they are treated with the super acid and also in the tertiary butyl cation as the main product. Why? Because this is the cation which is the most stable one. Now, when you talk about the stability of these carbocations, here the field effect also plays a role. And the electron donating effect of alkyl group, it increases the electron density at the charge bearing carbon, and therefore reducing the net charge on the carbon, and in effect spreading the charge over the alpha carbon. So again, you can see that this is CH3 plus, a primary carbocation, and its stability is lesser than the ethyl carbocation, then lesser than the secondary, and lesser than the tertiary. So here the field effect you can attribute the field effect for the stability, this order of stability. When the electron density is increased at the charge bearing carbon, now this actually spreads throughout the field and make it more stable. So this is also attributed to the presence of hyperconjugation. Like you can see that in the case of hyperconjugation, different structures of hyperconjugation, they are possible. And the 9 such structures are possible for the tertiary carbocation. So you can see that the tertiary carbocation is the most stable and therefore it is formed readily. Then the secondary carbocation and finally the primary carbocation, which is the least stable one. And therefore, it is difficult to form. While the ionized higher order carbon, they are stabilized by higher by hyperconjugation, unsubstituted primary carbons are not. How many primary hydrogens are there on the attached with the your positively charged bearing carbon? So that actually decides how many hyperconjugative structures are possible. And more will be the hyperconjugative structure, more will be the stability of your carbocation. So that is why this methyl carbonium ion is the least stable one, difficult to generate. But the tertiary butyl carbonium ion, it is very, very stable and easily formed. Now, the plus R group, they actually stabilizes the carbocation. So whenever a carbocation is present and it is attached to a plus R group, it will be having a stable structure. Like here you can see the CH2 plus attached to the OCH2, that is a methoxy group, which is electron relieving in nature, and therefore it is stabilizing the carbocation. Similarly, here the positive charge is present on this attached to the benzene ring, and here also so many resonating structures are possible. Here also you can see so the two resonating structures are possible, and therefore the stability of such carbocation will be more. So whenever the molecule enters into the resonance, automatically its stability will be more than other species. Now some carbocations, they are stabilized due to aromatization. And here you can see in the case of cyclopropanyl carbocation, which is stabilized due to the aromatization. And when the ring attains an aromatic behavior, when it attains an aromatic character, then automatically the stability will be more for such type of carbocation. Cyclopropanyl cation is stable due to the aromatization of the ring. Now we also have a stable allyl type of cation. So in the allyl type of cation, one double bond is also present attached to the positively charged carbon atom. And these allyl cation and benzyl cation, they are more stable than most of the other carbocations. So you can attribute their exceptional stability to the presence of the resonating structures. The molecules which can form allyl or benzyl carbocations, they are specially reactive in nature. Stable allyl cations, they have been obtained by the reaction between alkyl halide alcohols or alkenes by hydride extraction and FeF5 in SO2 or SO2ClF, so any of these solvents. So when you are using them, you can obtain stable allyl cations by these reactions. So here you can see this is the stable allyl anion cation. The positive charge is present on the allylic carbon, and these two resonating structures are possible. This is the benzyl cation, and the benzyl cation also, due to the possibility of the resonance, like you can see the positive charge, it can be delocalized on the entire ring. So that is how it attains a more stable structure, a positive state. Now, another most important thing is how we detect the carbocation. When the carbocations we are getting formed in the reaction, what is the technique which can be used to detect their presence? So we can use here the NMR spectroscopy. And in the NMR spectroscopy, you know that when we are using the H1 NMR spectroscopy, you actually determine the structure in terms of the hydrides, in terms of the H. So the cation, it form the cation formation from a hydrocarbon, it shifts the proton signal appreciably downfield, and that is due to the de-shielding of the proton. When the proton is deshielded, you see a downfield signal, and that is the case of a carbocation. So that is how you detect it in the by the presence of by using the NMR spectroscopy. Like you can see, this is a tertiary butyl fluoride, and in the presence of SB5, this fluoride is lost, and you get a tertiary butyl carbocation along with the SB F6 minus. Now let us see the next type of intermediate, that is carbanion. And we know that in case of the carbanion, they are also formed by the heterolytic fission of covalent bond. And here the carbon atom, it takes up the electron pair and attains a negative charge. So when carbon atom is containing a negative charge, you call it a carbanion. It bears a negative charge, usually with three substituents, for a total of 8 valence electrons. Now, formally, a carbanion is conjugate base of a carbon acid. You can write it like this: RCH, RC minus plus H plus. So it becomes a conjugate base of a carbon acid. Now, stable carbanions do, however, exist, although in most cases they are reactive. So even if they are stable, they are also very, very reactive. Like you can see here, one reaction in case of the crown ether. So this is the carbon containing hydrogen and the three other phenyl rings. And when the reaction takes place in the presence of NBuLi and THF, another crown ether is formed. And here the carbon is actually developing a negative charge. Now, because three phenyl rings are present on the carbon atom, this negative charge will be delocalized over all the rings, and therefore it becomes really, really stable. And it remains like this in the ionic state. Now let us see the generation and fate of the reactions, reactions of the carbon ion. So a group that is attached to a carbon leaves without its electron pair. Like when the proton is leaving, it leaves behind all the electron pairs. So when the electron pairs are left with the carbon atom, carbon atom will form a carbanion in which the carbon is containing one electron pair. A negative ion adds to the carbon-carbon double or triple bond. In that case also, the electron pair is transferred to the carbon atom, and it leads to the generation of a carbanion ion. Now, you can see that there is rearrangement of the electrons, and here the CO2 molecule is released, and this results into the generation of carbanion. So this reaction is very much similar to the generation of the carbocation by diazotization, by to the diazonium salts, when the nitrogen is released and a carbocation is generated. Similarly, here when carbon dioxide is released, and you get a carbanion. Similarly, when the negative ion, it gets attached on the unsaturated system, in that case also we get a negative charge on carbon, and we get a carbanion. Strongly reduced metal like sodium or lithium or magnesium, they can convert alkyl halide to alkyl sodium or alkyl lithium or Grignard reagent. So this is the reaction. RCl plus Li, one of the R group reacts with the lithium, and one reacts with the lithium chloride. And here you can see that we can also generate Grignard reagent by such reaction. Now, reaction of the carbanions. What are the common reactions which the reactive intermediates they are involved with? So, carbanions, they often act as a nucleophile. Why is it so? Because they contain one unpaired electron. And in order to achieve the stability, in order to achieve the electrical neutrality, they are searching for a species which is containing positive charge, and to which they can donate their electron pairs. So when a species is searching for the nucleus or positive charge, you call it what? You call it a nucleophile. So our carbocations, they are what? They are a type of nucleophiles. They are searching for a positive charge or electron deficient species. So in this equation, in this reaction, you can see R minus attacks on the CH3, not Cl, right? Because the Cl is what? This chloro group is withdrawing the electron pair toward itself and making this carbon as a positive one. So now the R minus will attack over it, and as a result of this, R CH3 will form plus Cl minus. So this is showing the nucleophilic nature of the carbanion species. Again, you can see this is the acyl carbanion attacks on one of the bromine atom, and one bromine is taken up the negative charge and it is released. So acyl bromide is formed. In the rare cases, the carbonium carbanion, they may undergo a cationotropic 1-2 shift. Like in case of the carbocation, we have seen anionotropic 1-2 shift. In the case of carbocation, we have just seen similar to those reactions, these carbanions, they are showing the cationotropic 1-2 shift. So two cations are lost consequently from a 1 and 2 position. So this is the reaction in which the first the phenyl group is lost. As a result of this, what happens? In the presence of the phenyl, now the rearrangement takes place and this type of compound is formed. So this is an example of the cationotropic 1-2 shift in which the rearrangement takes place. Then carbanions, they may be oxidized to free radicals. For example, you can see that this is a carbonium ion and this is oxygen molecule. When the electron transfer takes place, a free radical is formed. So one electron is retained with the carbon atom and other is transferred to the oxygen. So this results into the formation of O2 free radical and this propene free radical. Now let us see the stability and structure. So stability of the carbanion is directly related to the strength of the conjugate acid. Now greater will be the strength of the conjugate acid, lesser will be the stability of carbanion. Weaker is the acid, greater will be the base strength, and therefore lower will be the stability of carbanion. So you can see that the stabilization by sulfur or phosphorus. So here the carbanion is present in which the carbon is containing the negative charge. Now as a result of the rearrangement, now the electrons, they are getting transferred over the oxygen molecule, and after that several such structures are possible, and they make this structure as a stable one due to so many possible resonating structures. Similarly, here you can see that the negative charge is present on the carbon, and now it is transferred to the chain, transferred to the compound. And finally, due to the shifting of the electron pair at so many centers, the structure become a stable one. Field effect also plays a role here. So light, they are very stable than the corresponding simple carbanions. In the light, we have a alternate double bond present, and that double bond actually provides so many resonating structure to the carbanion. So that is how the lights, they become more stable when you are comparing them with the simple carbanions. And the carbanions, they are also stabilized by a field effect. If there is any heteroatom like oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, if any of these heteroatom is connected to the carbanionic carbon, that is the carbon containing negative charge, provided that the heteroatom bears a positive charge in at least one important canonical form. In one of the form, if your heteroatom is containing a positive charge and the carbanionic carbon is attached to some heteroatom, so in that case also the carbanions become highly stable, because in that case the charge travels so much inside the molecule and so many resonating structures are possible. So you know that greater is the resonance inside the molecule, greater will be the delocalization of the charge, and it actually lowers down the intensity of the charge and make the species more stable. So overall, you can consider that whether we are talking about the carbanion or carbonium ion, we are talking about the positive charge or negative charge, ultimately we are talking about the charge, and greater the delocalization of the charge, greater will be the stability of your species. So any factor which actually delocalizes the charge, which reduces the intensity of the charge, will make the species more stable. And any factor which intensifies the charge, which makes the charge more intense, increase it. Like if a plus, if a minus group, minus I group is attached to a carbonium ion, or if a plus I group is attached to the carbanion, in both the cases it will intensify the charge, and therefore it will make the species less stable. Even when you have so many canonical structures possible for a particular type of charged species, what is the significance of these canonical forms? They are actually representing that the charge is not located at one center. Rather, it is traveling throughout the molecule, and this represents the delocalization. So this is the thing which makes a charged species more stable. Now see the relative stability of carbanions with certain structural features. So the conjugation of the unshared pair of electron with an unsaturated bond, this makes the carbanion really stable, and the carbanion increase in stability with the increase in the amount of S character at the carbanionic species. So when the S character of a carbon is more, in that case the carbanion will be more stable, because that S character is actually the character of the nucleus, and it helps the carbon atom to take up the charge so easily and to hold it. So the S character will increase when you have a triple bond, right? In the triple bonded carbon, you have a sp hybridization, so a 50% of S character is there. Then in the doubly bonded carbon, you have sp2 hybridization, so a 33% S character is there. And in the case of sp3 hybridized carbon, when the charge is on the sp3 hybridized carbon, this S character is what? It is only 25%. So when only 25% S character is present, now this charge cannot be effectively held by this species. Rather, the effective stabilization will take place when you have 50% of the sp character, like in case of the acetylene. And you know that it loses the proton quickly. Acetylene is known to have a acidic character, right? If you remember, it quickly loses the proton and forms this negative ion. So why this happens? Because when it loses the proton, this makes this anion really stable. So that is how you follow the stability of carbanions. What are the factors which determine the stability and reactivity of a carbanion? So the inductive effect is the most significant one. Whenever the electronegative atoms are present adjacent to the charge, they will stabilize the charge because they will attract the charge towards themselves. So that will make the carbanion stable. The second factor is the hybridization. So if greater the S character, like I told you, greater the S character, greater will be the delocalization of the charge, greater will be the holding of the charge, and therefore greater will be the stability. So sp3 carbon is less able to contain that negative charge as compared to the sp carbon. Then last is the extent of conjugation of the anion. So the resonance effect, they can stabilize the anion, and this is especially true when the anion is stabilized as a result of aromaticity. So in that case, so many resonating structures are possible. That negative charge, that pair of electron, travels through entire ring, and so many resonating structures are possible which are actually delocalizing the charge. So in this manner, they make the carbanion more and more stable. Now how we can detect them? So because the negative charge is not delocalized in the carbanions of type CH3-, we can detect them by H1 NMR spectra. But otherwise, we can also detect the carbanions by the techniques of UV and visible spectroscopy of the different from the starting compound. And we can also trap the carbanion with some electrophile. And then after the trapping of the electrophile, we can detect them. So these are the references for today's lecture. That is all from my side for today. Thank you so much.